Hey guys, welcome back. OnePlus have started rolling out Android Q Developer Preview 5th version based on Oxygen OS. Yesterday we had the same build but which was based on Hydrogen OS. So today they have also rolled out the 5th build of Android Q Developer Preview based on Oxygen OS. So right now my device is running on the latest stable version of Oxygen OS on my OnePlus 7 Pro, which is 9.5.11. To install Android Q Developer Preview on your OnePlus 7 and 7 Pro, you just need to download the file given in the description below. So here is the file, which is Android Q Developer Preview 5th version. Download and place it inside the internal storage, but before installing make sure to take an entire backup of your device. So I have already downloaded and file has been placed inside internal storage. Then you go to Settings, System, System Update. You need to tap on the gear icon towards the right top corner. Select Local Upgrade and tap on this file. So here will be a warning message which says the system update will not affect your data, which means your data won't be affected, but for safety purpose you can take the backup. And then just tap on the install now button. Once the installation process is completed, just hit reboot. Device have been successfully booted up now. Let me show you the software information. By going to Settings, About Phone, here you can see my device is OnePlus 7 Pro. Under Android version is 10, security patches 5th August 2019. And I've been using this build from almost 24 hours, I have not faced any kind of issues. So after you install this, you'll find the launcher version has been updated and now launcher version is 4.0. In which they have added Android Q full screen gestures, which works perfectly fine, support full screen gestures in landscape mode. So this was a bug on the previous builds, but that has been fixed and now full screen gestures are pretty much smooth. You won't find any kind of lags with the full screen gestures. And now full screen gestures also supports landscape mode. There's a new feature added under camera. First, let's take a look at the camera version now. So camera version is 3.8.43, where they have added a feature called super steady mode in video recording. So here you can see, you can tap this icon on the right top corner under video section and you'll see this written which says super steady on, which will be a really helpful feature for people who does video recording using mobile. Here max video resolution is set to 1080. This will be a quick setting panel where you have all the options which were previously available on the stable version of Android P. Like you have screen recorder and Zen mode, and both of them are latest version. Under screen recorder you can now record videos up to 4K. Bitrate can be set max up to 24 Mbps. You can also change FPS to 60 FPS. And now we also get a feature to hide the floating widget when you start recording. Zen mode is also updated and now you get time options where you can set the duration of Zen mode. Towards the right hand side, we have the shelf available. This is your app drawer. Hidden space feature is still available where you can hide all the apps. And another thing what they have added with this Android Q is, now we get a dedicated game space application where you'll have all the collection of your games at one place. From where you can activate kinetic mode and graphic optimization options. After adding gaming space, OnePlus have removed the gaming mode from utility section. And all the OnePlus apps have been updated to the latest version. So now let's go inside the settings. Here we have Wi-Fi and internet, everything is working fine. Same goes for Bluetooth. Under display, we have the option of 90Hz refresh rate and 60Hz refresh rate. Video enhancer mode. Under ambient display, you'll find a new option of smart display which says intelligent info based on your specific time, location and events. We get few horizon lights available in which colors are blue, red, gold and purple. Another thing what you'll see under settings is, now we have a dedicated option for customizations. So here you can customize the clock style, fingerprint animation and the horizon lights. Then you have option to change the essence color. Tone can be changed to colorful, light or dark. Under themes you'll find three themes available, and first one is the carnival palettes. Then we have enough colors. And the last one is Nauset Dark. Which will apply a complete dark theme on your entire device. Also, if you want to apply dark theme on your applications, then what you can do is, you can go to Settings, About Phone, Tap on the build number 7 times until you see you are at developer now. After that, go to system, developer option, and here you need to search dark. You will see an option of override dark. Enable this, and now most of the system applications will adapt to dark color. So let's open up Play Store, and here you can see dark theme has been applied to this application also. Then we also have a few options to change the quick setting tile shape, which includes round, square, teardrop and round rectangle. So you can choose any of these. Later your quick setting tile shape will be changed. Then we have few icon packs available and same options under fonts. We have one is Roboto and second one is OnePlus Lite. Buttons and gestures, now we have the new navigation gestures. So these are the new navigation gestures, which is similar to Google Pixel devices, but it more looks like MIUI. We also have option to hide this bar, which can be done from here. And later they have also added digital well-being and parental control. So both of them can be found here in the settings section, where you can check your daily usage or your data. After that, if you want, you can also set in parental control. Then under utilities, we have all other options like OnePlus Switch, OnePlus Lab, which consists of DC dimming feature. But now gaming mode have been removed from here and we have a dedicated app called GameSpace. So guys, these are few new features added with Android Q Developer Preview 5th build. Now let's take a look at the benchmark results. So with Geekbench application, single core have scored 3588 and multi-core have scored 11400. And these are pretty great scores if you compare it to Android Pie. And these are the results with Antutu benchmark application, device scores 375,742. So guys, this was a quick look on Android Q Developer Preview 5th build of OnePlus 7 and 7 Pro. If you have any kind of questions, you can let me know in the comment section below. As of now, only this much in this video. Hope you like the video, and if you like the video, then do give me a thumbs up. Also, if you are new to my channel, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.